I just did. Check it out. 1, 2, yeah. 1 minute. Good morning. Buenos dias. Bonjour. Buongiorno. No. Buongiorno. Give me the accent. Buongiorno. There you go. Welcome to St. Andrew Presbyterian Church in this wonderful day of the Lord where we gathered. Did you know that early this morning you were woken up? Yeah. You thought it was the alarm, you thought it was you had to go to the bathroom or something like that. But no, ultimately speaking, God reminded you that today was Sunday. And ultimately speaking, you are here because God invited you and God inspired you to be here. I'm so sorry. Some of you may have been like, I wish Erin with our sister visiting, that she could have been at a brunch before the ocean. You know, it's still cool. The rains haven't come in yet. No, she chose to come to church. But that says a lot about each one of us. That says a lot about our God who loves us. And no matter what is happening out there, no matter what the winds blow outside of this building, he brings us together so that we can have fellowship with one another. One issue was mentioned to me was that we need to sell more tickets for that side. So today we're lopsided, you know, but that's good. Again, we are here to worship God. We are here to mindfully, to fully be aware. Like I said, that we're here because God brought us. But number two, be aware of the sounds, of the nice temperature, of the glass, of the music, of the smiles of people around you. That has been fully present. Show up here today because God has shown up. Amen? Let's go ahead and listen and put our hearts at ease as we listen to the prayer.
Thank you. Good morning. Welcome on this, it's the remembrance for 9/11 today. Just saw the news this morning, almost forgot about that. But we're going to do the call to worship. I will do one, and you will follow me with all. Today, we will practice mindful worship. But who is that we worship? We must know so that our worship is meaningful, memorable, and mindful. We worship the infinite, sovereign, creator, and parent of all light. We worship the wise, holy, most merciful, and gracious God, who is all love, forgiving, the builder of new things, and the good shepherd. Our scripture reading this morning is from Psalms 103. It's on page 554 in your pew Bible. Thanksgiving for God's goodness of David. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and do not forget all his benefits. Who forgives all your iniquity? Who heals all your diseases? Who redeems your life from the pit? Who crowns you with steadfast love and mercy? Who satisfies you with good as long as you live, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles? The Lord works vindication and justice for all who are oppressed. The word of the Lord.
Please join me in a moment of confession. Holy and merciful God, we confess to you our thoughtfulness. Okay. We confront our wayward today. We accept, Lord, our brightness and sin to turn to the past to recall your presence and kindness, as well as moments and situations where we know we failed you. Even still, your love remains. Let's have a moment of silence. And together, renew us with the strength that only you can give. Reveal yourself to us again as a God of grace. May we together decide our fellowship, our adoration, our prayers for you in the holy and loving name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Now join me in the assurance of pardon. In Christ we are loved. In Christ we are saved. In Christ we are redeemed. We are rescued together and hope-filled. In Christ we made new and forgiven. Praise be to God.
As we stand.
Oh, how good is Christ the Lord. On the cross he died for me. He has pardoned all my sins. Glory be to Jesus. Glory be to Jesus. Glory be to Jesus. In 3 days he rose again. Glory be to Jesus. Oh, how good is Christ the Lord. On the cross he died for me. He has pardoned all my sins. Glory be to Jesus. Glory be to Jesus. Glory be to Jesus. In 3 days he rose again. Glory be to Jesus. May the peace of the Lord is with you. Share it with one another with great love. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Call in. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you, Ken. Peace be with you. Peace be with you, Mary. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be. I told you it wasn't your grandma's church. Peace be with you. Good to see you again. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Testing. There you go. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. As we regather, I want to thank you again for being here. Those of you who may be visiting for the first time, or if you have been a regular visitor and you haven't filled out one of these forms, it's big, but it's because it's in large print for our convenience. And so it's here. Fill it out, please. You can put it in the offering plate, and we will bother you with emails. Okay? I promise that. Now we're going to sing two beautiful songs, and because today we're talking about mindful worship, They're not going to be happy, clappy songs. They're going to be soft, spiritual songs, because I want us to focus on the words. Not so much in pronouncing the words well, which is my issue sometimes, but in what do they mean to you as you sing them to God. So have that experience this morning. Be very mindful of the words we're singing, and feel free to express that adoration for God. In mindful worship, we are aware of the environment where we're, but we're also aware of our feelings, of our emotions, and we allow them to flourish in a proper way, obviously. So let's go ahead and sing, All People That on Earth Dost Dwell, and they will continue the segue into Fairest Lord Jesus. Can you bring it back to the last slide? Let's do this one again, this stanza, Beautiful Savior. But I'm going to ask Ruth for her to play it very slowly. Slowly. And for us to follow her in the slowness, because the first time we sing it is for our head. So we get used to it. The second time we sing it, we begin to understand it. And the third time we'll sing it, we should be from our bottom, from our soul, from our spirit. Can we try that? With just this stanza.
Thank you.
I don't know if you noticed that the first time we sang it at a higher volume. The second time that I interrupted and I invited you to sing the second time, we sang it at a higher volume. How many of you noticed how we almost whispered it the third time? Beautiful. You know why? Some of us, when we find ourselves in the presence of God, we don't have to yell. We can whisper. Because we know that God hears us. Even before the words came out of our mouth, Scripture says, the Lord knew the words of our hearts. Amen? Very good. I'm supposed to preach now? Okay. Again, welcome to St. Andrew. Today we commemorate the September 11 situation that we had 21 years ago. Who knew it was that long ago? America joined the rest of the nations as we finally received some bombs, as we have been sending bombs all over the world in the past. We got some. And we were freaking out. And this morning I heard, as I was listening to one of the worship services, how sad it was that it took that tragedy to bring America together, and how sad it is that it is going to have to take another one to bring us again together. What does that say about us? Dot, dot, dot. We also celebrate in the Presbyterian Church, every Sunday something else. You don't know it because you don't have a Presbyterian pastor's calendar. I have one of those, and it tells me every Sunday is something Sunday. Today, I like the one that we celebrate today because it's education. How many of us do like education? We value education. As Christians and as Presbyterians, Reformed believers, we have valued education throughout our heritage in this country. In 1910, there was a little college built in the southwest of Puerto Rico, which was called the Presbyterian Polytechnical Institute, in 1910. That same year, the Presbyterian Hospital was opened in San Juan, Puerto Rico, who saw me giving birth. I mean, who saw me being birthed. I didn't give birth there. I was birthed there. Let me get that English straight. Who saw me being born would have been the best words. It's still there. And yes, we love education. We have Eckerd College, 12 theological schools, 42 colleges and technical schools throughout the country that we support financially and we support in prayers. So please keep that in mind. And I wonder how we, who have benefited so much from education in our lives, could contribute for a younger generation to enjoy the benefits of a good education, which we know is the great equalizer in our country. Amen? Let us go to the purpose for which I am here supposed to be, and it is to share with you the word of the Lord. Today I have a very small passage to read, and is it in the next slide or not? I don't remember what the next slide is. No, okay, bring it back to the other one. I think you will remember this one. Once I read it, I'm gonna ask you to repeat it with me, okay? It's a very long passage, the passage of Matthew 22, 37. It says, Jesus replied, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind." Can we repeat it? Jesus replied, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your mind." Let's go. Today I continue my series in a Mindful Christianity. I call it Mindful Christianity, but the most popular title for this series would be A More Excellent Way. A more excellent way of experiencing God, a more excellent way of experiencing church, a more excellent way of engaging spirituality in our lives. We have placed the ad in our paper this month, which had that guy. I wonder who that is. Did he get paid to fall asleep in church that day? He probably did, because it's a stock film. But the ladies over here didn't get paid. And the whole ad says, you know, church is so boring and irrelevant. Many people complain, and they do say that they don't go to church because church is boring and irrelevant. They find it boring and irrelevant because they just go in. Maybe, as I thought we spoke last week, that they come into church as consumers, because we are consumers. We've been trained to shop. We even talk about it. I'm shopping around for church.
That is who we are. The next slide, please. That is who we are, and that is who, you know, we attend. So we go to church, and we expect to experience a wow experience. We expect to be entertained, number one. We expect to be to experience recreation in church. Don't talk to me about me, myself, and I. Don't talk to me about my sin. Don't talk to me about my brothers who is hurting. Just feel, make me feel good, make me feel better. I don't go to church to feel uncomfortable. I want to go to church to be, to have fun, to be entertained, and to be tickled in my ears so that when I walk out, I said, I had such a wonderful experience. That's consumeristic Christianity. What is out and missing from there is the basic element, the core of Christianity, which is to bring us together, not so much to have fun, but to be changed and transformed into the likeness of Jesus, so that we can bring our roughness and soothe it with one another, so that we can bring our doubts, our fears, our confusions, and be able to clarify it and bring the light of God into those situations so that we can then become witness to others that God is good, yes, and all the time God is good. But if we come to church only to be entertained, if we come to church only to have fun, to look pretty, to smile at each other and have a good experience, and they go home or to lunch, we are wasting our time. You see, my argument is, and my thesis is, that as we practice a more mindful Christianity, the more we become excited and inspired. Mindful Christianity is the idea of showing up. So the more we put of ourselves in the hour, in the experience, the more you engage, the more you pay attention, the more you are responding to the whole experience of what's happening in this hour, I can guarantee you that God will show up. God has shown up. Have you shown up? And if God has shown up in your experience, in your life right here, and you're engaging the Holy, you're engaging the Spirit, guess what? It will not be boring, and it may become too relevant. Becoming too relevant perhaps is being confronted with our own weaknesses, being confronted with our own unhealthy tendencies, being confronted with how we have chosen to hate others and not others. And that makes us all uncomfortable. But that is Christianity, which is not boring and is relevant. It is the Word of God that is active and alive, dividing and discerning between the spirit and the soul, between the sinful soul and the Holy Spirit to come together. But if we expect to be entertained, we will not become aware of the Holy in our presence. You see, a mindful Christianity is the practice of becoming fully aware of the moment, to show up fully, to be alert, to pay attention to your body, to your feelings, to your experience as we are together, as you are listening to my voice, as you're struggling to figure out what is he saying when he speaks so fast. That is being mindful. I also got to be mindful of my speed, and sometimes when I get too excited, to slow down my excitement, to listen and allow yourself to respond to the words that are being spoken, to react to every word, to allow every doubt to surface, every thought, every feeling, to show up before God with peace and curiosity. You see, because if God is going to show up where you're at, is it just going to be the light that's going to show up? There is a joke about a rabbi and a Presbyterian pastor in Far Rockaway, New York. Far Rockaway is in the Long Island South. It's very close to JFK Airport. And this actual geography does exist. There is a Presbyterian church, and across the street there is a synagogue. Okay? That actually is true. The rest of it is made up. So one day, the rabbi shows up at the Presbyterian pastor's office, and the Presbyterian pastor says, "Rabbi, what are you doing here? So glad to see you." And the rabbi said, "God has shown up in my temple." The good guy from Princeton says, "Yeah, right. Why, have you been hitting the Manischewitz too often?" And the rabbi says, no, for real. "The guy is in my temple. Come on, you gotta come up and see." So the Presbyterian pastor and the rabbi crossed the street and they went to the temple. As the rabbi opens the door, yes, the light of God is right, the Shekinah glory is right there.
And the rabbi asked the Presbyterian pastor very fearfully, "What should I do?" And the Presbyterian pastor replied, "Look busy. After all, he's checking on you." Look busy. Be engaged. Be part of the presence of God here with us right now. You see, our text this morning reminds us, and I think it is one of, is it next? Is it the following one? The following slide? Next one. Okay, next one. Okay, stop there. I didn't think I put it in. because the text says, listen to it again. We repeated it. It's very simple. It says, you must love your God with all your heart, all your soul, and all your... I thought it says, you should love your Lord your God on Sunday at 10:30, or just when you wake up in the morning and you remember you're alive, or before you go to bed just in case you don't wake up. It says, with all your heart, all your mind, all your soul. A very mindful text, we didn't think of it that way. It is a commandment. It is the greatest commandment. And it doesn't finish there. I just wanted to get this portion. It continues saying, love, to love our God with all our hearts, all your soul, and all your mind, and your neighbor as... Who's first? God. Who's second? Who knew that? This is when I have an issue with the gospel. I love God loving me. I love God being present in my life. I love God giving me all the blessings. I don't mind sacrificing for the Lord some things, except talking to people. When it comes to others, I make a joke about, I'm kind of shy guy. Those of you who are visiting, yes, I've lied. But it's work. I love to be alone. I love to be in my little cave. It's too big. I got to shrink it. But when I'm out, I'm aware. Now, yesterday I was at the shopping at Winn-Dixie, and I saw somebody from here. I can't remember who it was on Winn-Dixie yesterday, and I intentionally avoided them. Yeah. Hey, last week it was Winn-Dixie, five conversations. But I love it. I love it. Because those are opportunities where I am mindful that that encounter between you and I and Winn-Dixie is not coincidental. That encounter that you and I have, in the street or wherever, is not coincidental. Because I am mindful that God is also mindful of that moment. And God is working on that moment, not only in my life, but in their lives. And why in the world would God choose for you to meet a Presbyterian Puerto Rican crazy pastor in Winn-Dixie? At least to share a smile. At least to give a word of affirmation. At least to give a pat in the back. Maybe change you from one product to the other. And that's being mindful. Now, Jesus spoke of two texts, spoke of one text that is a very, very mindful text. It is basically when Jesus is speaking about mindful worship. When Jesus is speaking to the Samaritan woman in John chapter 4, he actually encounters her, and they have a conversation, and they end up talking about worship. And Jesus says the following word, that those who worship God should worship God in spirit and in truth. What does that mean, in spirit and in truth? Well, it means basically in the balance of our reason, but also in the inclusion of our feelings and emotions. It's a balance of both. Truth is the word, is reason, is our outward expression of the inner grace. With all our heart, we express that truth.
It is a balance between the intellect and the passion of expressions. It is the dance between the reason and feelings. To worship in truth is to also worship with honesty, intentionally, mindful, to know that the God of Israel, God's deeds, that's why we begin with who is God, so that we would know who are we worshiping mindfully. To worship in spirit is to be sensitive to the move, to the prompts, to the leading. As we sang the third stanza, or the third time, the same stanza, O beautiful Savior, fairest Lord Jesus, that third stanza, we lowered our voice. And maybe we did not know that we were lowering our voice because we were in the presence of the Holy. And that's a very natural response. Cindy began the scripture reading this morning with, Bless the Lord, all my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, all my soul. And then Paul reminds us of Romans 12, 1, and I finish with this one. And so, dear brothers and sisters, I plead to you to give your bodies to God because all he has done for you. Let them be a living sacrifice. In other words, don't kill yourself and give yourself to God dead. A living sacrifice, a holy sacrifice, separated, the kind that is acceptable for God, which is truly the way to worship. To offer our bodies is to offer our entire self, a living sacrifice of our actions, our passions, our dedication, our mindful worship. This is truly the way to worship God, fully present, fully aware, fully engaged, fully there, willing to listen, willing to see, willing to change, willing to love, with all your heart, with all your mind, and with all your soul, with all of who we are. The psalmist reminds us, Bless the Lord, all my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Amen. I forgot what I have in there. We have an affirmation of faith that I would like for you, if you could please join me in standing up. I will be the one. And again, be mindful of the words that we're saying. Be mindful of the imagery that these words have about us being with God and God being with us. We believe in God above us, creator of all things, sustainer of all life. We believe in Christ beside us, companion and friend, redeemer of all the broken pieces in our universe. We believe in the Spirit in us, advocate in God, guide us eternally. We believe in God's resurrection created world, where all things are fixed and all creation fits together in vibrant harmonies. We believe in God above, beside, within, God yesterday, today, and forever, the three in one, the one in three, we believe God. I want us to repeat that last statement, we believe God together, because it doesn't say we believe in God. Together, we believe God. Amen. You may be seated. Thank you so much. You're very kind. Not only are we going to pray this morning for our nation and what we commemorate today, but we also will be praying for sisters and brothers who are sick at home. Some are watching us over the streaming, and we send our blessings and our greetings to all of you. I don't know which camera I was on. But there are also other concerns that you may have. Do any of you would like to voice a concern? Yes, please, Sue, way in the back. Very good. For a friend of yours is in critical condition. Very good. Yes. A lady named Miva. We will pray for Miva this morning. Very good. Yes, Doug. Yes, they're both ill and they're both very good members of our congregation.
your granddaughter Kaylee. We continue to lift her up before the Lord. Yes, Roberta. Recovering. Wow. Wow, she had the bad one. Very good. So we pray for her, definitely. And for the Lord to bring healing and strength, not only to the ones that we have mentioned, but everyone that we have in our hearts, as we are mindful that we are in God's presence, and as we mindfully lift them up to the Lord and we pray. Dear God, we thank you that you have shown up. And sometimes those words are scary because we don't feel that we are fit to be in your presence, oh God. But yet through Christ, who is our Lord, who is our intercessor, and in whom you have placed us, because we are in Christ, then we can come before your presence fully, intentionally, and mindfully, God. You have heard our petitions, those that were spoken and those that were not spoken. But like we were reminded earlier, you know the words of our hearts and our minds, even before we speak them. Guide us, O Lord, as a people of love, as a people of compassion, as a people of forbearance and forgiveness. Walk with us as we practice your love, your forgiveness, and your joy. Continue to inspire us to make a difference in this town, and continue to revive the joy of a new spiritual home for many who, for whatever reason, have become spiritually homeless. Thank you, Lord, that we can be that home that seeks forgiveness and that realizes that we're not perfect. And we will make mistakes, and we will hurt one another. We would love to build reconciliation between you and your people. Thank you for Jesus, who commands us and encourages us to love you in such ways, mindfully, and to also love others as we love ourselves. And thank you, Lord, for his words that encourage us to pray together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us, sir, as we forgive. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. One of the also situations that happened during the weekend is that Queen Elizabeth II passed, and I'm not British, but my friends are, and I found out, I did not know this, that the king or queen becomes actually the head not only of the Church of England, but of the Church of Scotland. I didn't know that either. I found out, yeah. So today I'm proudly wearing my little emblem of the Church of Scotland. When I was honorary made Scot for a day. And then the lady who made me Scot for a day said at the end of the day, he's up for adoption again. Let us give to the Lord with great joy and generosity as we mindfully give with great generosity to God. Amen?
Thank you.
Please join me in a prayer of dedication. Generous God, thank you for all things that are created through you and for you. You are before all things, and in you all things exist. Accept the gifts we place before you now as you have accepted us. May the peace of God reign in our lives, the love of God surround us, the Spirit of God empower us, and the joy of God uphold us. Through your many holy names, amen.
Seated. Thank you. This morning, Paul Stratton and Cindy have been our worship. Cindy Kuchenmeister. Did I say that right? It is. Thank you so much for helping us. And we have a few announcements we want to share with our community. You can go ahead and move them as Metropolitan Ministers. We have a wonderful, this last Wednesday we had bingo, and we had a wonderful time playing bingo after the lunch. And Pauline joined us, and Pauline has threatened to play piano for us. That's wonderful. Our next slide is tacos and games on Tuesdays. Please sign up for that one. And then on the third Thursday, we always have pizza and a movie. Comedy night, October 15th. We have the Comedian is an Illusion is also a comedy and magician, 2-for-1. So, you know. And there's going to be desserts also served. November 18th and 19th. Did I get those dates right? Very good. November 18th and 19th from 8 to 2, we have the garage sale. Winter Arts and Crafts Show, December the 10th from 10 to 3. Very good. And at the end of the month, on Sunday, September 25th, we're going to have what's called our workshop design party. So if you are a singer, a craft, and a decorator, visual, spoken word, musician, join us in this party, and we'll get you busy for the Christmas season for all of us, okay? Are there any other announcements? Yes, please. Mr. Bill Guerrera has an announcement. Bill, I'll go over to you with a mic. This is number 6.
Today I brought a set of lists for the folks who assist the pastor every week with this worship service. These people give freely, and they are always here for you, and I just want to thank them for their work over the past year. And I brought you more work this morning for you to look at, some of which wasn't exactly right. And of course, you're so good that you make sure that I know how to get it correct. And I will do that over the next week. But it's been a long time since we sat down together to be able to talk about that. But let me just say to you, we are fortunate to have these people who are willing to do this, just like many other things that go on in this church. And we have a pastor here that's
enough. Stop lying. Thank you, guys. Yeah, he was going over life. There be no other announcements. Let's go ahead and be mindful of, we go outside, we're going to go and be the light, because the light has risen in our hearts today. Let's go with our flashlights out there, even in the day. Let's stand together and sing our closing hymn. Arise, your light is come.
Arise, your light is come. The Spirit's call obey. Show forth the glory of your God, which shines on you today. Oh.
all together. St. Andrew Church is called to welcome all to connect with God and one another through creative worship, innovation in ministry, and embracing hospitality by renewing and restoring the joy of a spiritual home. You guys, God, did God show up today? Did you show up? So I bet it wasn't boring and irrelevant. The grace of our Lord God Almighty, who is present with us, all around us, the love of His Son Jesus Christ, who pours it in our hearts even when we don't feel we deserve it, and the joy of the Spirit shall uphold you and the Church of Christ throughout all the continents, including the small islands of the ocean. Amen? Amen. Enjoy the postlude.